Goodwill Community Foundation, creating opportunities for a better life.
In part one, we talked about the basics of creating a pivot table. In this video, we're going to take a look at three more features called report filters, slicers, and pivot charts. Right now, this pivot table is showing us the regional sales totals for all the salespeople in our worksheet. However, I'd like to try removing certain people so we can see how their sales are impacting their regions. We can do this by adding a report filter, which can be used to narrow down the data in your pivot table. First, drag the salesperson field to the filters area. Then look to your pivot table and click the filter that's been added to the upper right corner. Next, check the option that says Select Multiple Items. Now we can check or uncheck the salespeople above, depending on who we want to include. I'm going to remove Michael Brennan, Richard Dumlau, and Shannon Thompson. When you're ready, click OK, and the filter will be applied. In this case, that means the totals have changed, and two of the regions have also been filtered out based on the people that we unchecked. If you like the way filters work, you might want to try adding a slicer next. Slicers make filtering even faster and easier by giving you access to the filters in their own separate pane. First, make sure you're on the Analyze tab, then click the Insert Slicer command. A dialog box will appear where you can check the filter you want. We'll use salesperson like before. Now we can just click the salespeople we want to see without having to go to the filtering menu. You can even select multiple adjacent people by clicking and dragging your mouse. To select more than one non-adjacent item, hold Control on your keyboard while you click. As you can see, the pivot table changes each time to reflect the data you've selected. The last thing I'd like to show you is a neat feature called pivot charts. Pivot charts are basically the same as regular charts, except they show whatever is in your pivot table. To get started, click any cell in your pivot table, then go to the Insert tab, and click the Pivot Chart command. A dialog box will appear where you can select the chart type you want, then go ahead and click OK. Now, any changes you make to the pivot table will show up in the pivot chart as well. For example, let's see what happens when we move these fields around a bit, so we can view each person's monthly sales data. With a pivot table, a pivot chart, and a slicer, we can look at the data in so many different ways, all without changing or deleting any of the original content. It's a great way to find whatever information you're looking for, or you can just experiment to see if you discover something new.